السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونسلي على رسول النبي الكريم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيد المرسلين، يا خاتم النبيين، يا شفيع المذنبين، يا أنيس الغريبين، يا رحمة للعالمين، صلى الله عليه وسلم. I've been asked to do a video on Eid Salat under the COVID-19 precautions. So since this year is very different than what most people are accustomed to, there won't be any large gatherings for the Eid, and you know whether Eid can be made or Eid Salat can be made at home or not, and under what conditions. Disclaimer before I really get started is that you know what I'm talking about is through the methodology or from the Hanafi madhab. And so from that perspective, there are differences of opinion, and some of those I may point out, but you know, for the most part, like I said, this what I'm saying is based on Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi's rulings. So the you know, so it doesn't apply or may not apply to everybody, and again, there are differences of opinion, but most of the people from the subcontinent, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, most of the people in Turkey, large following in Lebanon and Syria as well, where many people there are also, you know, follow the Hanafi madhab, as well as Iraq. So one is that, you know, under these conditions, of course, Eid Salat can be made at home, but you have to have a minimum of 4 male adults, 1 imam and 3 people behind him. And of course, Islamically, adult is not when somebody turns 18, but when they start puberty, then they passed on to adulthood, and so now they are legally of age Islamically. So 4 people of that stature should be present in the salat. The other thing here is that Salatul Eid, as Salatul Jummah, you know, these are congregational prayers for the community. So if you are making it at home and, you know, neighbor down the street finds out and he says, well, I'm coming too, you can't say, no, you can't come. You know, some of these restrictions that are placed upon us have no scientific background. And I'm going to get into that a little later on. I don't intend on making this very long, inshallah. But as far as the Eid Salat itself, again, for adults, I know that there are certain scholars who say at least 40, but in Hanafi, at least 4 is the minimum requirement. The Eid Salat, you know, the Salat is made first, and then the khutbah is after the Salat. And the khutbah is part of the Salat, so you can't just make 2 rakat and be done with it, you know, somebody needs to give the khutbah as well. But as far as the Salat itself, basically in Hanafi you have 6 additional takbirat, so you know, basically 3 in the first rakat and then 3 in the second rakat. And the way this is done is, and I'll demonstrate, is that you know, the person, you know, just like you're gonna start Salat, you know, you say Allahu Akbar, you tie your hands, you read, recite Thana, Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabaraka ismika wa ta'ala jaddaka wa jalla thanaka wa la ilaha ghayruk. Or Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabaraka ismika wa ta'ala jaddaka wa la ilaha ghayruk. And then before starting Surah Fatiha, you make 3 additional takbirat. So you say Allahu Akbar, leave the hands hanging. Allahu Akbar, again, the hands hanging. And then the last time, Allahu Akbar, now you tie your hands. And you recite Surah Fatiha and any other surah, preferably Surah Ala if you know it, but if you don't, any other surah is fine. You finish the rakat and then you come back up, you know, and you start the second rakat. Second rakat, you continue like you would normally, recite Surah Fatiha, Surah Ghashiyah if you know it, if you don't, any other surah. And then before going into ruku, 3 additional takbirat. Say Allahu Akbar, 1. Allahu Akbar, 2. Allahu Akbar, three, and then you say Allahu Akbar, and then you go into ruku. And then you finish the salat like you would normally finish the salat. And so so this is basically the salat itself. After the salat, the imam will stand up and give the khutbah. Simple khutbah, it doesn't have to be complicated. You know, basically if you want to do the minimum to fulfill the requirements, you know, say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, and Salatu Salam on Prophet Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Simple khutbah for those who you know, you can, somebody could use this if they wanted to. You could recite all of Surah Fatiha, but simply saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen is enough. So you could simply say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And khutbah is over. You know, sit down, stand back up, give the second khutbah, you repeat the same thing, you know, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And done. You know, so that's simple. You know, of course, you can look up other khutbah online if you wanted to, if you want to give a longer khutbah or add, you know, words to it, and it's, you know, but this fulfills the requirements, and this is enough that most people could do it very easily. Some of the ways salat is being made these days is not salat, you know, and coming from a scientific background, if you look at this social distancing salat, you know, where everybody's standing 6 feet apart, you know, my question to them is, okay, what's the research behind this? You know, what is the research that you should be standing 6 feet and not 7 feet, or 2 feet, or 3 feet? You know, Rasulullah SAW said stand shoulder to shoulder. If you look at the science, you know, if somebody coughs or sneezes, then that goes way further than 6 feet. So if I'm standing 6 feet from somebody and he coughs or sneezes, it doesn't really matter from a scientific standpoint. These are random numbers that they've thrown out.